every community has a different process of going, seeping in into. In India, what happened with a lot of communities, when you work, you take a very hierarchy stand with your clothing and with your confidence in your body, which also like a colonizer in a way. It becomes difficult because you don't want to be that. So you have to cut down. How much you cut down, it doesn't really. So they start telling you a story which is not true. Till for 2 years, 3 years after that, they might tell you the reality, what it is. Here, it was completely different because in the community, I have worked with certain European community in Switzerland and stuff like that, but this was completely different. I felt it would have a similar structure because we were both colonized by the same people. So I thought there would be a similar structure or a feeling or something, which actually helped me in one way, because when I would talk to a Aboriginal person, and we would say, we were colonized by the same people, and I would joke that, but we threw them away, you know, and they would take it very positively. I said, yeah, we couldn't, you know, but maybe they wouldn't have been so comfortable talking to a friend who is also a white Australian. It's not, you know, easy. But then some people, because it's a small community and you cannot make jokes. It's very sensitive, very sensitive. So sometimes it was good to come to Perth to make some jokes, or not thinking that who will get hurt, because somebody else would, you know, and they would add to the joke. But there, it is very intense. That whole process was kind of intense, and they drag you into that whole thing. So, and it's very interesting that one community really looks at the whole family structure, which relates to India in some or another way. And one community is not bothered about the family structure, you know, and it's a contrasting. But one tries to be more over sensitive and over conscious about not hurting the other community. The other community is not bothered maybe in that kind of way, but also because it's something. It was always reminding me of a word which in Europe it has come, which is the worst word I've used is outsider art. You know, that feeling started coming within me in that kind of way. So I becoming a gray zone in the community was interesting because there is certain, there is no grayscale. There is black and white. We have grayscales. So that's much more complex in a way. But here the complexity is completely different, which sometimes you don't understand, you know. So what the white community would tell me might be completely wrong, bouncing back in the other community, because sometimes they forget that I am not white, I'm brown. You know, so there is a kind of, so it, some things were allowed for me. So, like I was like said, that you cannot go and just introduce yourself. They have to come and introduce you. So I waited and waited, and in the end they really told me, why you didn't come and chat with us? I said, I thought in your community, but not for you. You know, suddenly you find, I could have shifted my position, which was interesting. So the second term would be more interesting, because I have my own build-up notions. Now I don't have to rely on other sources in a way. But this is completely, it's not possible also in 6 months' time to complete. It would, 2 years, 3 years, it really takes. But then I have been reminding myself that I'm not doing a PhD. I'm just, but I also don't want to go just superficial, like a tourist. You take a superficial thing and do make a statement, and that's a wrong path I am fearing. So I'm trying to avoid that path. But this journey has been completely different than the other interaction to the community, because here there was nobody who is sourcing me as an artist. There are nobody in the town would be an artist. So normally in the community, somewhere or another, you go through an artist or something to make yourself some or another way comfortable. But here the zone was totally unknown zone. Yeah, and for me, both the community was unknown. Even the white community or the Aboriginal community was unknown to me. How do they behave, or how they would, you know? There are some people who are completely racist, will make you really feel uncomfortable, you know? But then look at the Aboriginal community and you learn to ignore